Hello, Flat Earth researchers, debaters and debunkers. A gaggle of globe Earth believers are heading off to Antarctica in December to see if they can observe a 24-hour sun, basically to see the sun doing a circle around them without ever actually setting. And in their minds, this is the final experiment, because it will apparently prove once and for all that the Earth must be a spinning globe if we can see a 24-hour sun in the south and then the same in the north at a different time of year. Now, the globe Earth believers that are organizing and participating in this so-called final experiment believe that seeing a 24-hour sun will disprove the flat Earth, because they're referring to the flat Earth as this azimuthal equidistant map of the continents that's centered on the North Pole and makes Antarctica appear like a ring around this circular map. So, of course, if you see a 24-hour sun going around you in Antarctica, that would be impossible if you're using the azimuthal equidistant map as your flat Earth model. Now, the globe Earth believers believe that they have this undeniable, irrefutable working model of a globe Earth that fits with everything that we can predict and see happening in the sky in the real world. Well, that is kind of true, but what has never been brought forward or discovered was any actual curvature on the surface of the Earth. Almost 500 years ago, we were introduced to the Copernican model, the heliocentric model of an Earth being another planet going around the Sun. But this wasn't achieved by observing or measuring any curvature on the surface of the Earth. It was just simply assumed by looking up in the sky. And so really, a final experiment should be an actual measure of curvature, if you really wanted to shut up the flat earthers. But when you ask for one, the globe Earth believers cannot produce a measure of curvature. They will in fact go to the assumption that horizontal level ends up being a curve. Now, if you live in the real world, you know that level doesn't ever curve. But, of course, if you assume a certain model to start with, then you can assume that the globe Earth has a certain radius, and so that would give you a certain amount of curvature over a certain distance. Now, one of the ways we've been deceived into believing that we live on a globe is the simple trick of converting distances across the level surface into degrees. And then, of course, when you have 360 degrees, you have a circle, or what would assume to be a slice of a spherical Earth. So instead of just saying that I've traveled a certain distance and that must translate into a certain number of degrees, let's see if we can actually measure the change in degrees from the start point to the end point of a journey. And this was an idea that was brought up by a friend of mine called Leon, who's a very practical man. And he has an idea of using an inclinometer or a clinometer, or which is otherwise commonly known as an angle finder. Now, there are digital angle finders available online that have a bubble as well. And they don't cost too much. And you could easily take this on a plane with you to see if there is a difference in the angle from the start point to the destination. And all you really have to do here is use a formula to convert the miles traveled into degrees. So you can do that by dividing the miles by 69, because we have a circumference of 24,901 miles of a globe Earth. And if you convert that into 360 degrees, we've got a conversion factor that is about 69 miles per degree. That's not nautical miles, that's just regular miles. So Leon's idea to actually measure curvature rather than just assuming it is quite a simple one. You take one of these digital inclinometers on an aircraft with you. It's pocket-sized, so it should be quite easy to do. And once you've reached a cruising altitude and you're flying straight and level, you then calibrate the inclinometer so that you establish its level. And from then on, you record the changes in degrees seen as the aircraft makes its way to the destination. Now, of course, there will be changes either way, plus or minus of a few degrees as the aircraft goes about flying through the air and maybe the angling up or down at certain points. But by the end of the journey, you should have a bias that would show you measurable curvature, that is equal to the number of degrees compared to the distance that we've actually travelled. And this would be a final experiment. And if someone's going to do a final experiment, it certainly should be part of the journey to measure curvature on the way. Why not double up your experiments and see if you can actually produce another proof that would actually shut up the flat earthers if you could measure curvature rather than just calculating curvature based on the distance and then converting it into degrees. With this particular method, we should actually see a change in the number of degrees. So let's have a look at the kind of measurements we would expect to be able to make if we were flying around a curved Earth with a circumference of 24,901 miles converted into 360 degrees, giving us a conversion factor of about 69 miles per degree. So you basically just divide the number of miles travelled by 69. Now let's start with Punta Arenas, which is the departure point to head to the Union Glacier Camp in Antarctica for the final experiment to observe the midnight sun. And that will actually be a total distance of 1,865 miles. So that should give you a measurable curvature of 27 degrees. That's quite a significant amount that should be measurable, not just calculated because you've travelled a certain distance, but actually measured as a change in the number of degrees. Now, you could do this anywhere if you like, any flight. A lot of us are flying about here and there from time to time. You could take one of these things in your pocket and just try it for yourself anywhere in the world. We should be able to measure curvature wherever we go. So let's take Bristol Airport, for example, in the UK, heading to Corfu International Airport, and that is a total distance of 1,359 miles. And that would give you 18.84 degrees of curvature. So that's quite a short flight, but you would still see a considerable amount of curvature. Now, if you are heading from Perth Airport in Australia, for example, and heading to Union Glacier in Antarctica, that would be a total distance of 4,684 miles. And so the degrees of curvature you should be able to measure then is almost 68 degrees, or 67.88 degrees to be exact. And if you are going to Punta Arenas Airport from Perth, then that would be a total distance of 10,000 kilometres or 6,552 miles. And that would give you a 94.95 degrees of curvature. Something that really should be measurable if you're claiming to fly around the globe Earth. And if you do want to do a final experiment that eventually convinces flat earthers that the Earth is not level and it is a globe, then you have to come up with a way that we can all measure curvature. A repeatable experiment. The predictions are already there based on the model. So if you cannot measure any change in level from a departure point to a destination, then nothing has changed. Just because you say that level is curved, because you're referring to a model with a globe Earth that has a particular radius, that doesn't change what level actually is in the real world. If you want to prove that level is curved, you have to be able to measure that curve. And I think Leon's come up with one of the best ways that anyone can actually measure this in a truly repeatable scientific measurement of curvature. But it would seem to me that it's only flat earthers or real truth seekers that are interested in actually conducting such experiments. All you'll get from globe earth believers is excuses and claims that level is actually curved because you can calculate it based on a model. But real science is conducting real measurements. And if you're not prepared to do that, then the flat earthers will continue to believe that the Earth is indeed as we see and measure it. So go ahead, guys, include a proper measurement of curvature in your final experiment, and maybe that way you will finally shut up the flat earthers. Of course, if you can't, then maybe it's your turn to shut up and accept reality without having to make up imaginary interpretations of level being curved just to fit with a globe Earth narrative. Let's see what you guys can come up with. You're all very smart, apparently. Thank you very much.